come back. They took a walk in the woods and they never come back. Metal from the radio, it rang out through the fields.
Salisbury was shocked today as police discovered the body of a male Caucasian between the ages of 21 and 24 in a wooded area just outside of town. Our own Channel 29 reporter Jim Vance is on the scene. Jim?
Today at 4 p.m., a body was discovered in a remote wooded area off Route 50. As of this time, the body is still unidentified. Earlier, we spoke to Sheriff Daniels about his possible leads.
Well, we have no leads at this time. However, we have found and questioned several people who have come in contact with the deceased.
With us here now is Steve Nixon, one of the few people we have found that has been questioned by Sheriff Daniels.
Well, I was coming back from Ocean City 3 days ago, and I saw him hitchhiking. He looked okay to me, so I gave him a ride up to town.
I can take you.
So this is Salisbury.
This is it.
I'll tell you, I really appreciate it.
Later.
As soon as it comes around. Feeling pressure? Call Love Lines.
Excuse me, miss. Get it. We ready?
Go for it, man.
I was told you could shed some light on this mystery.
Yeah, well, who told you that?
Sheriff Daniels.
Well, that's a bunch of bull. Look, I'm gonna say this once and only once. The guy came into Super Soda 3 days ago and just bought 2 cases of beer. Please excuse me, I have to go to work.
Cut. You knew the victim.
Well, I knew him a little bit, not really that well. I was having a party at my house, and he was there. I got him to buy us some beer.
Yo, man, come on in. We're just starting to bash.
Yo, man, thanks for grabbing a case of beer.
Aw, man, thanks for the place to stay, man.
I want y'all to meet my friend Francis. Francis is Susan, Gary, Becky, and Lisa.
He's back! Yeah, and we partied real late. He got kind of drunk, and he fell asleep on my couch, and I don't know, I went to bed, and I woke up that morning, and he was gone. Is this going to be on TV?
Cut.
We need one more interview, and we can call it a wrap.
Okay. Sir, excuse me. Do you live around this area?
I live up on the right.
Have you noticed anything suspicious in the past 3 or 4 days? Hey, man, I really appreciate this.
Hey, come on, we gotta go, come on! Goddamn, come on, goddamn. Go.
I'm heading to D.C., but I gotta make one stop, right? All right?
No problem, same direction I'm headed, man.
get out.
Get a car and take the bag.
Man, what the hell?
Shut up! Shut up! Turn around! God damn it, slow the hell down.
Man, where the fuck are we going, man?
Just shut the hell
up. What do you want?
Move! God damn it!
Move, man.
Don't you just shut up! Shut up! Just shut up! Come on!
Look, man, I'm telling you, I don't know where we're going, but I don't have much money.
Man, I don't want your damn money. Your shit money.
Look, man,
I don't want it. Just shut up and walk. Just shut up.
Look, man, no further. We're not going any further. This is it. Look, you take my money.
I don't want your money.
Take it off.
I don't want your money.
What do you want from me, man?
I don't want your money.
You're a crazy son of a bitch. I said, have you noticed anything suspicious?
Nope. Can't help you.
Well, it's obvious that there are many unanswered questions surrounding this murder. The most frightening being, who is the murderer? And is he still lurking around Salisbury?
Thanks, Jim. In national news today, President Reagan denied reports of a rekindling of his love affair with Bonzo the chimpanzee. Reagan stated, and I quote, "That love affair has been over for 10 years. I'm happily married with Nancy and intend to stay that way, unless someone comes along with big jugs."